Good afternoon, students, and welcome to this tutorial for Inglés 4, which is your course. Today we're going to be reviewing some of the grammar that you're going to find in your book, Ventures 4. Today we're going to be looking at noun clauses, adjectives and adverbs, until and as soon as. Let's start. Noun clauses. It is important that you understand what a clause is. So I wrote the question, what is a clause? Well, a clause is a part of a sentence that has a subject and a verb. I have written two examples so you can see what the noun clause is. People say that Jerry plays the guitar. That Jerry plays the guitar would be the noun clause. Also, you will find noun clauses in a question. Do you think that she is smart? That she is smart is a clause. In your book, you are going to study noun clauses using that. Now, the structure for these noun clauses are the main clause plus the noun clause. Let's take a look at the example that I have written. The police believes that Manuel stole the car. If you're translating this to Spanish, that would be que. For example, la policía cree que Manuel robó el carro. Let's take a look at these two other examples that I have written. The first one is a question. Do you think that English is important? ¿Piensas que el inglés es importante? As you can see, I have underlined the clause in this question. I have also written that between parentheses. That means that that's optional. But it's only optional when you have a noun or a pronoun after that. The next sentence. Charles believes that he can finish his project in 1 week. Charles cree que él puede acabar su proyecto en una semana. Again, you have that between parentheses because that's optional. Let's move on to the next topic, adjectives and adverbs. Now, to start, you need to know what an adjective is and what an adjective does. Adjectives modify or describe a noun. And what is a noun? A noun can be a person, a thing, a place, or an animal. Let's take a look at these three examples. Carlos is an intelligent person. Intelligent is the adjective, which is describing the person. Benny is an excellent singer. Excellent is the adjective that is describing the singer. Maria is a bad actress. Bad is the adjective which is describing actress. Now notice that the position of the adjective is right before the noun, okay? Bad actress. The adjective goes before the noun, actress in this case. Adverbs. What is an adverb? Well, an adverb modifies verbs, adjectives, and other adverbs. But the grammar that you have in your book only works with the verbs. Example, Mary wrote her report very clearly. Clearly is the adverb that describes or modifies the verb wrote. Now, the form of the structure of the adjective, the adverb would be adjective plus ly. Look at this example. Clear is the adjective plus ly becomes an adverb, clearly. Quick, an adjective plus ly becomes the adverb quickly. Now you have to be careful because you also have some irregular adverbs that sometimes change and sometimes they don't change. Like the case of good, the adverb would be well. And for fast, the adverb would be fast, the same. Let's take a look at these three examples. Jenny dances gracefully. I have underlined the verb and the adverb is with red letters. Gracefully would be the adverb that modifies the verb dances. John ran fast. Fast is the adverb that modifies the verb ran. Carol speaks Spanish well. Well is the adverb that modifies the verb speaks. The next topic, or the next grammar that you will find in your book, is the use of until and as soon as. I have written the translation for until and as soon as because the grammar is similar to the one that we have in Spanish. So until can be translated to hasta o hasta que. And as soon as can be translated to tan pronto como or tan pronto. Examples. The nurse stayed with the patient until he finished his lunch. If you were to translate this part, this would be: la enfermera se quedó con el paciente hasta que él acabó su almuerzo. Now, in English, you can also use until at the beginning of the sentence. Until the patient finished his lunch, the nurse stayed with him. Let's take a look at these examples using as soon as. As soon as the patient finished his lunch, the nurse left. Again, if you were to translate this to Spanish, this would be: tan pronto como el paciente acabó su almuerzo, la enfermera se fue. Again, you can see that as soon as can be used at the beginning of the sentence or in the sentence. The nurse left as soon as the patient finished his lunch. And that's it. That's the information for the first tutorial. Thank you.